guys, and welcome to episode 15 of Minecraft Mega Construction City Edition with me, Potter Plum.
And me, Howlin' Westy. Is this episode 15?
I believe it might be episode 15 or 16. I feel like episode numbers, we always get them a little mixed up. We're a little bit bad for it at this point.
Well, either way, it's the episode after the ice cream parlor.
Yes, it is. I will admit, we've had a few issues off camera, sorting out recording issues and stuff. It's still not entirely sorted. I think like we've done a lot of building off camera as a result of it, but I think we've now kind of got recording issues like mainly sorted. I think we've been having problems, haven't we, Corey, with like full screening Minecraft and crashing it. So we've not been able to record for like full screen, yeah. Which is a little annoying, so I've had to resort to using OBS rather than Shadowplay to record. But anyway, enough of the boring shenanigans regarding recording. Corey, would you like to start touring off what we've been doing off camera, since there was a lot to digest for people who haven't seen?
Okay. So first, we will show some of the new shops we've done. So we've added to the baby shop.
Yeah, we've got a little bit of got some cribs, got some milk, got some... Are these meant to be nappies, I'm guessing?
They're meant to be baby growers.
Okay, I thought they were nappies, if I'm honest. I mean, oh, this is a shop. I haven't seen myself, actually. Yeah, the pet shop, I believe, is next door.
Some of the pets are missing.
Yep, here's the pet shop. So yeah, some of the pets appear to have disappeared, but I mean, the majority of them are still here, right? I mean, it's not the end. It's not the end of the world.
Can I just quickly in the pet shop?
I think a lot of our shops are actually deskless. We've got like a knickknacks shop. Is this a knickknack shop? This is the knickknack shop. I think Corey was going to call it like knickknacks.
Yeah, over here we've got a post office.
Oh, nice. This is a build I haven't actually seen. I think it's a nice sort of short and sweet post office, I think. It's kind of nice. But they got a lot of bit of lighting.
Yeah, we've got an empty store here.
Yeah, we've got quite a lot of empty stores. I mean, Corey has made this really quite a big build. I mean, it's a little... I feel like this part of the town is going to become quite frame ratey the more and more stuff we put in. I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do a quick killer E. Equals that. See if I can get rid of any ground entities that have accumulated on the floor.
Okay, so we've got the flower shop.
Yep, we've got a nice little... just a basic little florist. We've got the candle store. Yeah, I mean, we have pretty much ripped on all of the names and stuff. Like, there's been so many names that we've like ripped off, like Danky Candle, Pizza Hat. I mean, back here, I believe we showed you this last time. I think Corey's now made the toy shop a little bit bigger, and we've got like a gadget store. But Morgan's and stuff you saw in the last episode. If you saw the quick build episode, you will have seen Pizza Hat. We've now moved it over to here as well. The Pizza Hut is still in the high street, but we now have it also in here as well, which I think is pretty cool.
We do also have an arcade now as well.
Yep, the arcade is pretty. It's pretty new, I think. I mean, we installed a few more mods off camera, so we've now got. I believe we showed you these last time in one of the quick build episodes. We've got the arcade machines, which I think are pretty dandy, I would say.
Yeah. So what are we building in this episode?
I think we should build some shops, given how many empty shops we actually have. Although I think we aren't actually...
Should we show the exterior?
Yeah, I believe the first thing I'm going to show you, the guys, is the elevator, given we have quite a few new... We've got some gifts and stuff now to show off for the floor labels, so you can see what floor you're on, and without having to necessarily check... you know, exactly where you are. You can just look at the sign. So this is also the car park down here. The golden glob obviously didn't fit on the elevator panel, but it's meant to be the golden globe. And you'll see why that floor is called the golden globe in a second. I just want to show you that all the elevator has been, all the redstone has been covered. It's all been kind of integrated in quite nicely, I believe. I think, let me just call the elevator. So this is floor 5. Yeah, that is definitely a nice, helpful addition. And I think I'll show you guys the golden glob floor. So Corey, would you like to come and demonstrate the exclusivity of the golden glob?
Before you show them the inside of the golden glob, do you want to show them the outside of the golden glob?
Well, you've just put me right back down to the car, to the ground floor again.
Okay, I'll call you up.
Hang on. Yeah, I'd literally just gotten up to that floor and then you called it right back down. Anyways, I'll show you guys what the golden glob is. So it's literally just a giant sphere. And for me, it kind of cements that this series is meant to actually be mega construction. Oops, sorry about that, guys. I think it cements the fact that it's meant to actually be a mega construction build, if you will, rather than just being, you know, like, hey, this is a mega construction series, but we've not actually built anything mega yet. So now the actual city, the actual shopping center now is going to be the Golden Globe Shopping Center. And if you ask me, I think it is really pretty cool.
So, yes, the Golden Globe is our original idea. Never been a thing before. We are the first people to come up with the Golden Globe.
So I think, Corey, would you like to show people the exclusivity of this club? So, for instance, if I want to go up there and I have VIP access, which I believe I do, I think, Corey, have you added yourself to the VIP access?
I think you might have added me.
Yeah, I believe I added Corey to the VIP access. Yeah, I have. I believe, have I taken his name off? Yeah, okay, so I haven't actually... So if I now remove Corey's permissions on this guy and I reset the shield, now I should have access to the Golden Globe, and now Corey should no longer have access to it. Can you? So you can no longer get through it, Corey?
No, I am stuck from going through that.
Yeah, so I'm obviously going to add Corey back to it. So this is it's just an RF Tools shield projector, and then you add the shield template frames that you want to add, just if you're curious of how we've done this. And then you can like set them to be a certain block. I think I've just done a transparent shield and a yellow colour, and I'm just powering it with a flux port. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to say I want, if I go to player and I then type in Howling Wessie, I can then add him to the list and bump it up. So now his priority is above the default solid priority. So now Corey should have access to the Golden Globe elevator.
And we now have the glass elevator as well.
Yep, so it goes up. We haven't, I believe, I kind of want it. We also have another shield up here, just so if anyone like managed to sneak through the first one, they couldn't get through. I think Corey needs to, Corey said he was going to chisel and bits over that flux plug, I believe. Although, I don't know how that will affect the shield templates, so I don't know if we necessarily are going to be able to do that, actually.
It's possible.
You look, like, the NPC, look, he can't get in, look, because there's another shield here, look. So we have shielded in the main elevator, so there is no way Corey can actually... NPCs can get in here.
I don't want these villagers getting in anyway. I haven't trusted a villager since the Scouring Spy.
So yeah, so I think what I'm going to do in this episode, guys, is start working on the nightclub exclusive VIP area. So I think I'll get to work on that, guys, and I'll be right back. Okay, guys, we're back. So we've got like a few ideas we kind of want to do for this place. In fact, I might actually leave it at nighttime, because I think this place really does look cool at night. And it kind of adds to that sort of feel.
I mean, this is a nightclub, kind of, so we should... keep it nice.
I think so, yeah. I think while we're doing this build anyway, so I think of course we need to stick some like beer mugs and stuff on the I don't know, like, would you be having like, I feel like a really posh place should be like, I want champagne, I don't want like your dirty
beer.
I've got
the wine racks back here.
I've just realized the beer taps the wrong way around, aren't they? It's not a self-service. Could you imagine a bar and it has self-service on the beer taps?
Yeah, this one.
So what else is there? Is there any, like, champagne bottles or anything cool?
You can get wine bottles.
I might put that there and just pretend it's, like, something else. And not a reaction chamber.
Why don't you just put a cash register there?
Do we need, like, a fridge?
I don't think so.
I think the fridge I could potentially integrate like that, which I think looks kind of nifty.
Could we not integrate the fridge where the fence is? Could we like put it there?
Potentially, I guess. One thing I'm now kind of looking forward to is putting some slabs on the... Because do you think if we have like some stairs and slabs maybe for the bar? I'm trying to attempt to see what sort of slabs would work. We can have maybe like we can, I think we've got... There's a few that I've got my eye on, Corey. Which one do you think looks kind of cool? Because I think rather than having like that complete look, if we had something like that... I can't
say this.
Oh, what, the golden sheet metal from Immersive Engineering?
Yeah. Did we not use sheet metal for the car? The, what's it called, petrol station?
I believe we used... Yeah, I think we maybe used another type of sheet metal, yeah.
Nice.
Do you want to have it go all the way around, or do you just want it to have it be like...
I think all the way around this part.
Oh, we do actually have some nifty umbrellas. Do you think we should try and like get some... some beach umbrellas. Can you imagine that for the build, having some nifty umbrellas?
Maybe not.
Imagine that. I mean, it looks kind of cool, but I mean, it does kind of clip and look a little weird. I do kind of love what sort of happened to Mega Construction there, how it's gone from being like, oh, we'll have like 40 minutes of like building footage to building something okay, and now we're kind of going, okay, let's build loads of stuff off camera and just update the guys and build something small in between. I don't know, I think I'm really, really looking forward to when this world goes up for a world download. I don't know about you, Corey, but I have very high hopes for when this goes up for a world download. What about you?
Yeah, same. I think we're not really close to it yet.
Yeah, I wouldn't say we're quite close to a world download yet. I've also had a bit of a nifty idea, by the way. You know those beacons we had before?
Yes.
What do you reckon to that?
On top of the lift.
Yeah, because it's made out of vibrant alloy, isn't it? Which you can use for...
It's nice.
I do wonder if there's any, like, champagne or wine glasses or anything. Is there any, like, wine glasses or anything from DecoCraft? There's wine bottles, which I guess we could maybe have on, like, these tables? Okay, I mean,
they're, like, smaller coffee tables, but... If we, like, get some regular-sized tables, we could definitely do that.
What sort of tables do we have on offer? I don't necessarily want to use the tables that have... What if instead of the coffee tables, what if we had, like, these sort of tables? Oh, that looks kind of cool. Yeah.
What sort of table?
These sort of tables.
That does look a bit more bougie, I will agree.
Because, I think, I don't know, I quite like the look of the oak tables from Bibliocraft.
The dark oak ones look especially fancy.
Imagine, though, what this place is going to look like, though, when we have, like, a bar in here and, like, some disco NPCs. Because the good thing is, the NPCs won't, like, despawn. So if we have like some party guys up here, hopefully they won't disappear, because I don't think there is anywhere, unless we deload the chunks, there is nowhere for these villagers to go. These are all like top end C-Cap subscribers.
Yes. They bought the official C-Cap's candle.
There you are. I've killed off like the shady looking villager. Do you like our barman villager, by the way? He's actually stood there at the bar, look. How funny.
I like it.
So I think what we'll do, guys, is we'll be right back when we have something more to show you guys. Okay, guys, so I think what we're going to do is probably end the video off a little... Maybe like a bit of a short episode, I guess. We've pretty much finished the Golden Globe. I suppose this episode was kind of a bit of a fill-in for all the work done off camera. And kind of like doing the crown jewel feature of the supermarket. The shopping centre room. I keep calling it the supermarket. So one thing I want to show you guys is the stuff we've done. So I've got like some neat little Nike statues and stuff down at the door now. We've got some arcade machines. We've got some jukeboxes. We've got some nice sort of little... got some sofas and some candles and some wine and some stages and a nice bar now. And I honestly think it's pretty kind of nifty now. Let me just turn my sound down just a fraction. So Corey, is there anything else you'd like to show the guys before we end off the episode?
I am going to teleport you outside to show off the exterior.
I think, oh, what? So now we've got all the crazy stuff inside of the sphere. I think that looks kind of cool, actually. Like, definitely from the outside, I really like the look of this. I think because originally when we were doing this, we had like a half sphere, and we're going to have like the dome be on top of the building. But then I think Corey suggested we... then make it into a sphere, and I was like, well, if we're having a sphere, why not like prop it up and make it like its own thing? I mean, realistically, it looks like it should just fall apart, I mean, in terms of physics, but I mean, I really kind of like the look of it.
Excuse me, I made this structure to support it, okay, and then it looked like the Golden Globe trophy, and we're like, oh, let's make it the Golden Globe.
Yeah, I mean, we had some like discussions about what we should call it, and I was like, Golden Globe, and Corey was like, we can't call it Golden Globe. And I was like, But it is a Golden Globe. I mean, it literally looks like a Golden Globe trophy at this point. So yeah. it literally is the Golden Globe shopping centre. Which, to be fair, I mean, it's a mammoth shopping centre. I mean, when you actually consider the sheer size of this thing.
Definitely. I mean, you can see that Golden Globe from really far away.
I would definitely agree. So anyway, thank you for watching, guys. I hope you've enjoyed it. Goodbye from Post and Plum.
And how much do you?